Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by Makerdemy. This is Nidhi and I am a part of the instructor team at Makerdemy. In this episode, we will learn how to perform gesture recognition using TinyML. In this video, we will learn via implementing a project how to get started with TinyML. We will be implementing a machine learning model on an Arduino board for creating a gesture recognition system based on an accelerometer. For the simplicity of this project, we will recognize only two gestures, namely a punch and a flex movement. Before getting started, let us find out the hardware requirements of our project. We will be using the latest Arduino Nano RP2040 board to create this project. You can also use any 8-bit microcontroller to achieve the same. To detect motions, we will be using the MPU6050 module that combines a 3-axis gyroscope and a 3-axis accelerometer on a single chip. Neuton is the TinyML framework that we will be using to train data and generate prediction models. Neuton is a no-code automated TinyML platform designed to build neural networks automatically with a little machine learning experience and embed them into any microcontroller. The project is divided into three steps. First, we will see how to capture the training dataset. The second step will be to train the model using Neuton. The third step is deploying and running the model on an Arduino board. Let's get started. First, we will interface the Arduino Nano RP2040 board with MPU6050. Find the circuit diagram in the video description. Communication with MCU takes place using the I2C interface. To work with MPU6050, download Adafruit MPU6050 Arduino library in Arduino IDE. Go to the library manager and search for the library. Click on the Install button. To verify your sensor, go to Files, Examples, Adafruit MPU6050, Plotter. Run the code, upload it to the Arduino board, and open the serial plotter within the Tools menu. Set the desired baud rate as per your Arduino board and shake the sensor. If you see a graph like this, your circuit is ready to collect sensor data. The first step was to capture the training dataset. The simplest way to do this is to repeat the same two motions of punch and flex and store the result in a file. For sensor data acquisition, find an Arduino sketch in the GitHub repository link provided in the video description. There are some dataset requirements given by Neuton.ai. The output of the Arduino sketch is formatted according to the dataset requirements. First, run the sketch with gesture_target set to gesture_0. And then run the same code with gesture_target set to gesture_1. You have to perform at least 60 motions, 30 for the punch movement and 30 for the flex one. Copy the serial monitor output of the two motions in a text file and rename it to trainingdata.csv. You can find this file in the GitHub repository link provided in the video description. The second step was to train the model with a Neuton TinyML. Click on the link provided in the video description. Click on the Start for Free. Sign in with your Google account. Click on Add New Solution. Give it a unique name. Click on Next. Click on Upload Dataset. To upload your dataset, you have to create a free trial account on Google Cloud. Click on Setup here and follow simple steps to create a free trial account. If you need help setting up your account, kindly go to the user guide link provided in the video description. Over here, you can select a Gravity plan. It is a free plan. Once you set up your account, you can upload your dataset here. Click on Upload CSV file, select your CSV file, and we are done uploading. Click on OK. In the target variable, search for the target and select target. Click on Next. Binary classification is already selected in task type, as we are only using two motions in this project. In metric, select accuracy and enable TinyML. Click on Start training. The training process might take some time. Once the training is completed, go to Prediction and download a model for embedding. To deploy the model on Arduino, create an Arduino sketch inside the downloaded model folder. Two main functions in Arduino sketch are Neuton_model_set_inputs to set input values and Neuton_model_run_inference to make predictions. To set input values, make an array with model inputs, that is 300 float values in our case. Pass this array to Neuton_model_set_inputs function. When the buffer is ready, call the Neuton_model_run_inference function. This function returns an index of the predicted class and probabilities of each class. Like this, you get the probability of the predicted class. You can find the code in the GitHub repository link provided in the video description. Upload the Arduino sketch to your board and open the serial monitor. Now grab the circuit in your hand and perform some motion. The model will try to guess what type of movement it is and how accurate the prediction is for each detected motion. 0 is for punch and 1 is for flex. If the prediction accuracy is less than 0.5, the model does not make a decision. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.